Okay guys, so you're welcome once more to this DMSI channel. My name is Dr. Melina Bright, like you already know. And today is April 25th and is the World Health Organization's Malaria Day, or World Malaria Day as it be put. Okay, so what is it about this World Malaria Day? Of course, it's a day set aside by the World Health Organization to throw more light on malaria and then to bring awareness to it. And then to also see that malaria and its burden is cut short to the barest minimum. All right, so on today's World Malaria Day, the theme for this year is Zero Malaria, It All Begins With Me. All right, and I've titled this video, How to Eradicate Malaria from Your Life. Okay, simple. Now, a lot of us tend to commonize what malaria is. But it is a problem enough for the World Health Organization to have decided that a day be set aside to commemorate malaria and then to remind us of all the problems that malaria brings with it. But I'm just going to, in a bit, to ensure that we don't put up a very long video, I'm going to be very precise. So I'm talking generally about the things that you can do, why the world is actually talking about how to eradicate malaria, let's take malaria entirely from us. Or from our lives. It's a good thing, no doubt, all right? So a lot of things have been proposed. I want to say a big thumbs up to every person who is doing something to try to see that the burden of malaria is reduced, especially here around us in most recent times. I want to say a big thank you to the likes of Ned Nwoko and his foundation that has been bringing so much awareness to malaria and actually is making efforts to doing a number of things, which include trying to develop a fund proposals or fund researches that tend to provide vaccines for malaria, as well as to see how the malaria can be eradicated. So it's simple, we all know what malaria is, all right? And we know that the causative organism or the causative thing, what causes malaria, the vector really is the mosquito, all right? And we know how mosquito comes about. These things, I would like to go from the policy or from the principle that simple things occur simply, all right? So the drains in around us, the drainages that are blocked around us, the dirty environment, the huge dump of dirt at your backyard or even a kilometer from where you stay, all these usually will constitute a proper breeding ground for these mosquitoes that eventually will cause malaria. So if you want to take mosquito from you, there's only one way to do it. If you do not want to actually get mosquitoes to bite you, because if you don't get mosquito bites, you're not going to get malaria. And the way to go about it is to eradicate all these venues or eradicate whatever it is that usually will cause the proliferation of malaria. And it's simple. So the way to do it is to make sure that the drainages are not blocked, that the water, the canals around you are flowing properly, that there's proper dumping of refuse, or that refuse are not kept, are not dumped in a place where people sleep densely, and as well as sometimes it may not necessarily be that people stay in a place, it's a place where people stay densely, all right? So another way, you see a lot of us have this, what you call trash cans, trash bins, right? Right in our compound or outside the compound, and then most times, you wait until they are filled before somebody will probably come and take them away for proper disposal. Even that also will act as a breeding ground for the mosquito, the vector that causes the malaria, and so malaria won't be far from you. So these are just simple things that I think you should do. The number one thing I think, the way I want to put it, is that you keep your environment clean. And keep your environment clean will include that your drainages are not blocked, they are flowing, that your refuse dump are emptied as at when you, and even when before they are empty, that they are always covered, and then that your dump, the dump sites should be far away from where people stay as much as possible, and then that your, of course, you could a lot of people have been talking about fumigation and the need to now use what we call insecticides and stuff like that. Good enough, but as a matter of fact, I think there are just two ways to actually go about it. You could use the pesticides or what we now are calling vericides, all right? And then again, you could also use mosquito net, right? So there's, I like to say that there's no gain in arrogance, okay? The insecticide treated mosquito nets are the most important thing that you actually could use in curbing malaria, in curbing mosquito bite, and therefore curbing malaria. So irrespective of how beautiful your house may be, no matter how much you try to keep mosquitoes away, if your environment is not it's not in tandem with the things that we've mentioned, the likelihood that mosquitoes will find their way into your house is high. All right. Sometimes the nets that we even build, before you know, sometimes they are torn, you don't know. Sometimes probably they get expired, because there will be times that you actually will be wondering where mosquitoes got into the house, but somehow they just find their way in. But if you make it an habit to always sleep under the mosquito treated or insecticide treated mosquito nets, and then some people get so used to it that they are unable to actually stay anywhere else or not sleep anywhere else or less under the net. And once that happens, you may as well say goodbye to malaria. Now, that's basically what we can do about the environment. But generally, I also want to talk about the thing that people should also do. All right. So you do not, once you have the symptoms of malaria, which will include fever, nausea, which is feeling of vomiting or even vomiting itself, abdominal pain sometimes, and even chest pain, muscle pains, all right, headache. These are the common signs. Even cough sometimes are the common signs of malaria fever. That's not to say that once you have these symptoms, it is malaria. So you don't have to make yourself the doctor who is making the diagnosis, because you heard Dr. Mena Bright talk on the MSI channel that these are the symptoms of malaria, all right? There's still need for you to access healthcare as soon as possible, as soon as you begin to feel these symptoms, and so that a doctor can see you and confirm that what you actually have is malaria, so it could get treated. Now, when people get diagnosed of malaria and then they get treated, that also helps to prevent other people from getting malaria, because of course, the mosquitoes are not, malaria does not inherently live with them. They are not genetically, malaria is not genetically in them. It is until they get in contact with somebody who has malaria and then feed on the person that have malaria, then go back to feed on someone else, that is eventually depositing malaria on the next person. So if those who have malaria get treated, get diagnosed early, and then they get treated early, the likelihood that also the rate of people having malaria will be reduced is also increased. All right, so there are a few little things, simple things, not very highfalutin. You don't really need plenty money, not you don't have to have money to, like, you want to buy equipment and all that to keep yourself safe from malaria. And if you do these few things, you may actually be able to eradicate malaria from your life. All right, so thank you for watching our channel. Subscribe and also make sure you share to your friends. Malaria is a general problem. Everybody who has been sick of malaria don't want to be sick again, want to know how they could prevent it. And these tips that we've given on this video may just help you. So if you think there's somebody who you think they could also help, also share this video with the person, or you could watch with the person. Alternatively, get the person to subscribe to our channel. And I do believe that they would never regret that they did. Thank you once more.